Hello everyone, my name is Svetozara and in today's video we're gonna be talking about the history of the Bulgarian folk instrument called tambura. This is the first video dedicated to tambura, which is a part of a series of videos that me and my sister created for a project which is funded by National Culture Fund Bulgaria. In this project, we're going to present you two of the Bulgarian folk instruments. I'm gonna talk about tambura and my sister Kalina is going to talk about gadulka. The project includes 5 informational videos about each of the instruments, in which we're going to tell you more about the history and construction of the instruments, as well as some of the greatest musicians who have contributed significantly to the development of gadulka and tambura. You're gonna see a few music videos as well, in which we're going to play some of our favorite pieces composed by the most famous Bulgarian musicians. The goal is to popularize those instruments beyond the borders of Bulgaria. And finally, we want to say a special thank you to the National Culture Fund Bulgaria, because without their help, we wouldn't have been able to make this project a reality. And now let's get to the video. I hope you enjoy it. Now let me tell you a little more about the tambura. It is a string folk musical instrument. It has a pear-shaped body, which is made of wood, and it also has 8 steel strings. The sound is obtained by pulling the strings with a plectrum. It is typical for Bulgaria as well as for Macedonia, Iran, Afghanistan, Pakistan, India and Croatia. Such lute instruments were first known to the Assyrians, and the oldest records are from a few thousand years BCE. However, the tambura gained real popularity only with the rise of the Persian Empire, which, through its dominant role in the ancient world, managed to spread the tambura throughout Asia. Subsequently, numerous modifications and similar instruments appeared in various Eastern and Western cultures, which were brought from those of the ancient Asian and African civilizations. The Bulgarians, on the other hand, brought the tambura to Europe and thus helped to spread its different varieties in other European countries. The names by which the tambura was called throughout different eras in different places also varied greatly. In the Middle Ages, for example, it was known throughout Europe as Tambur Bulgara. After Bulgaria was conquered by the Ottoman Empire, it was primarily Turkic, Arabic and Persian names that were used for its many varieties. According to the famous historian Konstantin Iratik, in some areas the instrument was called drunkia, and in the Dospat Plain, for example, people used the Turkish word bailama, which was popular in Anatolia. The name comes from the corresponding Turkish verb, which means to connect or to tie. The tambura was also called saz and karaduzin, and all these names were used by Turkish shepherds from the Rhodope Mountains. The French scientist Fétis wrote that bailama, also called baglama, meant a children's tambura because of its small size. However, the names of the musical instrument related to the Bulgarian ethnonym were predominant. Some of them are Bulgara, Bulgarina, Bulgarika, Bulgare, Bulgaria, etc. The Bulgarian tambura is still known by these names in many countries such as Egypt, Afghanistan and some European countries as well. The French music historians contributed significantly for establishing the name and varieties of the Bulgarian tambura. The first researcher in European historiography who documented and gave detailed information about the name and spreading of the Bulgarian string instrument was the Frenchman Guillaume André Vieuxtemps. As a member of the research team that accompanied Napoleon's expedition in 1798, he visited the lands of the Ottoman Empire, including Egypt. During this expedition, Vieuxtemps described in detail with texts and images the local instruments, their musical characteristics and the way they were used, classifying 5 different types of tambura, which you can see on the screen. In the 19th century, 2 other French explorers, Fétis, whom I have already mentioned, and Racine, during their expeditions to Egypt and Algeria, discovered an identical 6-stringed instrument, but a little bit larger than the one described by Vieuxtemps. they documented it under the same name, Tambur Bulgari. Thus, the two main types of Bulgarian tambura became known to the world, small 4-string Bulgaria and large 6-string Bulgaria. Recently, some sources suggested that the instrument was brought by the Ottoman Turks. However, this is not true. It was probably brought in the 7th century with the arrival of the Bulgarians. Proof of this are many murals. For example, the images of string instruments similar to the tambura from the Khrelov Tower of the Rila Monastery dating from about 1334 to 1335, the Church's Nativity in Arbanasi 1597, the Transfiguration Monastery with the Wheel of Life, which was painted by Zachary Zagraf in 1849, as well as the Introduction to the Mother of God in Blagoevgrad 1844, and many others. The fact that the tambura and its varieties are depicted in our cultural monuments gives the right to conclude that for centuries it has been an integral part of the life of Bulgarians. This instrument is typical of authentic Bulgarian folklore, and all this information proves it. Nowadays, the Bulgarian tambura is being taught in the largest cities such as Sofia, Plovdiv and Varna, as well as in smaller towns and villages. If you enjoyed this video, you can support us by liking, commenting and sharing it. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so that you don't miss any of our new videos. You can also like our Facebook page and follow us on Instagram. The links will be in the description box. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments down below or message us on any of our other social medias. We'll be more than happy to answer you. There will be a new video every week, and next time I'm gonna tell you more about the construction of tambura. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye!